In this lecture, we'll be looking into the various factors affecting the choice of armature core length and armature diameter in a DC machine. So, which all factors have to be considered while fixing the armature core length and armature diameter? So, first let us consider the factors affecting the armature core length. The first factor that we have to consider is the cost. So, while considering the cost, it is found that the cost for manufacturing a machine with a larger core length is less. That is, for a machine having a larger core length, the manufacturing cost will be less. As the core length increases, manufacturing cost decreases. This is because in a machine with a larger core length, the ratio of inactive copper to active copper will be less. So this ratio will be less in a machine with a larger core length. So let us consider a machine with a larger core length. This is how its armature coil will look like. So this portion of the armature coil is known as the active copper. This portion is also known as the active copper. That is, portion of a coil which is embedded in the slot is known as active copper. And this part, that is the conductor which is used for connecting the two coil sides, is known as the overhang or the inactive copper. This is the inactive copper from here to here. This is the inactive copper. Inactive copper. So this portion is known as inactive copper because it does not take part in EMF production. So it is just for providing the end connection between these two coil sides. And as this portion is inactive or it does not take part in EMF production, it is desirable to reduce the amount of this inactive copper. If inactive copper is less, the machine will be cheaper. So in a machine with a larger core length, this ratio of inactive copper to active copper will be less. So here active copper will be more. As the core length is more, amount of active copper will be more. So inactive copper will be less compared to the amount of active copper, and hence the machine will be cheaper, manufacturing cost will be less. So if we consider the same machine with a, if that same machine is constructed with a smaller core length, what will happen? Suppose it is having a smaller core length. So then also, the same amount of inactive copper is required, but the active copper, amount of active copper decreases. So this ratio, inactive copper to active copper ratio, increases in a machine with a smaller core length. When smaller core lengths are considered, the amount of inactive copper will be more compared to the amount of active copper. So the inactive copper requirement is same in both these cases. Okay. So as the core length increases, the amount of inactive copper decreases compared to the amount of active copper. Okay. So larger core length anengil nammal inactive copper ayita active copper ayita compare cheythu nokumbo inactive copper de amount avade koravayirikkum. So that machine will be cheaper. So with the increase in core length, the machine becomes cheaper or the manufacturing cost decreases. So the second factor that we have to consider is the ventilation. Okay. So ventilation. So this will be our armature core, and outside that we have our stator. and these are the air gaps through which ventilating air flows through. So if a machine with a larger core length is used, there is a chance for the central portion of the armature core to attain a very high temperature. So ventilating air will be passing from this side as well as this side. So as it moves forwards, as the ventilating air moves forwards, it gets heated and its heat transferring capacity reduces. So the central portion of the core attains a very high temperature. So our armature core, and on both sides there will be air gap. Ventilating air is flowing through the air gap. Okay. So in radial ventilating systems, ventilating air will flow from both the ends and it will radially flow through the machine and then leave it like this. Okay. So as this ventilating air is moving forward, its temperature increases. Alright. ഇങ്ങനെ പോകുന്ന വഴിയിൽ ഹീറ്റിനെ ക്യാരി ചെയ്താണ് പോകുന്നത്. സോ വെൻ ഇറ്റ് റീച്ചസ് ഹിയർ, ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് ഹാവിങ് എ ഹൈ ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ. സോ ഇറ്റ് കാനോട്ട് എഫിഷ്യൻ്റ്ലി റിമൂവ് ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ ഫ്രം ദ സെൻട്രൽ പാർട്ട് ഓഫ് ദി ആർമേച്ചർ കോർ. സോ ഇഫ് യു ആർ യൂസിംഗ് എ ലാർജർ കോർ ലെങ്ത്, ദ സെൻട്രൽ പോർഷൻ ഓഫ് ദി ആർമേച്ചർ കോർ വിൽ അറ്റൈൻ എ വെരി ഹൈ ടെമ്പറേച്ചർ. സോ വിത്ത് റിഗാർഡ് ടു വെന്റിലേഷൻ, ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് ഡിസൈറബിൾ ടു യൂസ് എ shorter core length. So these are the main factors to be considered while selecting the armature core length. So about ventilation, as the core length increases, ventilation becomes poor. So cost and ventilation are the two factors considered for fixing up the armature core length. So now let us see the factors affecting the choice of armature diameter. So in case of armature diameter, the first factor to be considered is the peripheral speed. Okay, so what is peripheral speed? So as the name indicates, it is the speed at which the armature periphery of the armature rotates. So it is known as the peripheral speed, and the peripheral speed is given as VA is equal to pi d into ns meter per second. So where d is the armature diameter and ns is the synchronous speed in RPS. So peripheral speed is directly proportional to the diameter of the armature. And for a DC machine, the peripheral speed should be in the range 15 to 50 meter per second. So d should be selected in such a way that the peripheral speed is in between 15 and 50 meter per second. So even if the theoretical range is given as 15 to 50 meter per second, in actual cases VA should not exceed, VA should not be greater than 30 meter per second. Okay. So the practical cases demands a maximum value of VA 30 meter per second. VA should not exceed 30 meter per second. So if peripheral speed exceeds this value, what will happen? Excessive centrifugal stress will be developed in the machine. If the armature is rotating at a very high speed, armature periphery is having a very high speed, there will be excessive centrifugal forces. And in order to withstand this, the bands of binding wires for the overhang has to be made extra strong. Bands of binding wires of the overhang. So we have to make these binding wires extra strong. So I have shown you many diagrams of overhang. So you know how overhang looks like. So overhang portion of the conductor of the armature coil remains outside the slots. So we have to bind it properly. There will be a number of conductors in the overhang, and we have to bind that conductors properly. So the wires used for binding that overhang is known as binding wires. And if the peripheral speed of the armature is very high, we have to suitably carefully bind that armature coils, overhangs. That overhang has to be carefully or properly bound. So the binding wires should be made extra strong in that case. And also special methods are required for preventing the flying out of overhang. So if the periphery is rotating at a very high speed, there is a chance for the overhang to fly out. So in order to prevent this overhang flying out, we have to go for special methods also. So while choosing the armature diameter, always keep in mind that the peripheral speed of the armature should not exceed 30 meter per second. So now the second factor to be considered is the pole pitch. So we know what pole pitch is. So pole pitch is the distance between two adjacent poles. So if our armature is like this and we have, if our stator field system is like this and having four poles, this is our armature. Okay, then the distance between two adjacent poles is known as the pole pitch. And we can calculate the pole pitch as pi d divided by p. That is perimeter, circumference of the armature divided by number of poles will give us the distance between two adjacent poles. So it can be calculated as pi d by p. Pi d means circumference of the armature divided by number of poles. So there are certain values for pole pitch for each number of poles. So for each number of poles, there are certain ranges, already specified ranges for pole pitch. Suppose if we have a two-pole machine, there is a standard value for pole pitch. The pole pitch should be in between certain limits, a particular mm to a particular mm. So there will be a range for the pole pitch. And while choosing the armature diameter, we have to ensure that the pole pitch lies in the specified range. So pole pitch is pi d by p. So for each number of poles, if we are constructing a two pole machine or a four pole machine or an eight pole machine, we have to make sure that with the selected diameter, the pole pitch that will be obtained should lie in the specified range. So these are the two factors that are to be considered while fixing the diameter of a DC machine.